The Great White North fights back against COVID-19. Canadian universities are at front and center tackling this crisis and tracing its impact on our lives. This is Universities Fight COVID-19 from Radio Western. Each episode, we tell you about COVID-19 related research and commentary coming out of Canadian universities. Today's episode is from McMaster University and Macquarie University. The COVID-19 crisis has impacted businesses around the world. Owners have shut down their companies. Employees have lost their jobs. Amidst these trying times, many businesses are finding creative ways to survive and operate, but also support the fight against COVID-19. This crisis is different from disasters previously faced by businesses and communities. Hurricanes, floods, or wildfires, for example, strike hard, strike fast in tight geographic areas. Businesses play a critical role in restoring communities. They provide economic growth, employment, and essential goods and services. They provide hope for recovery. But the current crisis has disrupted the ability of individuals and businesses to physically connect. We also don't know how long this disruption will last. There is no immediate solution in sight. And many businesses are adapting to this challenge. Restaurants are shifting to takeaway and drive-through options. Grocery stores are highlighting home delivery. Vet clinics are using curbside drop-offs and pickups and are bringing medicines and food to customers waiting in cars. Arts and craft schools are offering at-home kits and online art lessons. Gyms, fitness studios are broadcasting online classes. Companies are expanding their capacity to help employers work from home. Places that must remain open are altering their physical environments. For example, Loblaws and other grocers have created special shopping hours for more vulnerable customers and installed plexiglass shields at their stores. Many manufacturing firms are shifting to products required in the new pandemic environment. An Italian firm is using 3D printers to replace broken respirator valves. Canadian and American automotive suppliers are collaborating to produce ventilators. Distilleries are producing hand sanitizers. And an apron and chef gear manufacturer is collaborating with a doctor to design and start producing face masks. Conferences are looking to virtual platforms to continue important network events. After the crisis passes, businesses may return to a new normal. For example, working from home may impact commuting, congestion, and quality of life. Large conferences may give way to small gatherings. Companies may focus on creating and sustaining local supply chains rather than rely on global ones. Manufacturers may diversify their product base. The crisis has also revealed the importance of healthcare and medical research, medical supplies, telecommunications, and food supplies. Future businesses are likely to focus more on these. This story was adapted from the Conversation article, Businesses Step Up to Make the Products We Need to Get Through the Coronavirus Pandemic, written by Brent McKnight, a strategic management professor from McMaster University, and Martina Linnenluecke, professor and director of the Center for Corporate Sustainability and Environmental Finance, Macquarie University.